Hey everybody, Rob here. It's time for a couple of petty revenge stories. First one, neighbor antagonized me all year, so I quite literally gave him a taste of his own medicine. Let's jump right in. Join our Discord channel so you can have a chat with yours truly, and also for the giveaways that are coming in the near future. Also, if you haven't yet, please consider subscribing for more daily Reddit stories. In college, I had a neighbor who will henceforth be Benny. And this neighbor, he was not a considerate neighbor. For example, he watched TikTok at 3 a.m., connected to his Bluetooth speaker, which he so politely pointed directly at the wall to improve sound quality. He piled his garbage in front of my door when it didn't fit on the sides of his door, that I had to cut a path out when I wanted to leave. He dumped pee from a bottle under my door when he thought I reported him for one of his many crimes against the people of the floor. Absolute degenerate of a neighbor. I was, however, fairly friendly with one of his roommates. On one crisp November evening, this roommate let me in on a little social experiment he was conducting. In Benny's closet, in a black garbage bag, was a pumpkin from Halloween. Originally, it was just supposed to smell up the closet until Benny found it, but Benny never did find it. Move out day was in late December. I was packing up in my room and my roommate comes back and says, "Hey, what's up with the bag of soup outside?" After some initial confusion, we discover that this fine bag of moldy, wet, desecrated remains is from the pumpkin. We decided that the best course of action for this beloved sack of soup was placed caringly and carefully in front of Benny's door, since he must have misplaced it. Benny was not fond of this development. He knocked on my door, banging like the headboard of a wedding bed, and demanded to know why I had put my garbage in front of his door. So I reminded him that it was actually his garbage. In fact, it was actually his compost at that point. Obviously, he apologized for the misunderstanding, took out his own garbage, and left me alone, and we both went our separate ways, since we only needed to tolerate each other for a few hours. No, actually, believe it or not, he balled it up and threw it at my head. The only logical choice, really. This angry water balloon sailed through the sky, through my door and into my bed frame. I readied a nearby jar of salsa for the coming battle, but he had already turned tail and waddled back to his room as quickly as his enormous girth would allow. Now that the history is set, it's time for revenge part you've all been waiting for. I went over to the pumpkin, which luckily was still contained in its fine plastic vessel. So I crept ever so slowly towards Benny's room, pumpkin bag in hand, shot put style. When Benny opened the door, we made brief eye contact. I saw him, he saw me, he saw Excalibur in my hand. And in that moment, he knew his fate. And as he moved to close the door, I loosed the pumpkin on its most holy journey. I can say that I understand how Olympians feel when they break a record with a Herculean act of strength as the pumpkin sailed through the door, into the side of Benny's chair, and exploded as furiously as one might atop a toilet on Taco Tuesday. The black fireball, the stench everywhere, all over everything, the ceiling, the floor, his clothes, his heater, him, everything. Like the morning after a fresh snowfall, if that snow was black as night and smelled of rotting fruit. Best part, his roommates and everything he owned was shielded by what I can only explain as angels sent to protect him from my righteous wrath. It's not too often that you can smell a story, but this one right here, I can definitely smell, and it's putrid. On to our next story. Think you can outdrink me? Think again. Let's jump right in. Saw someone else post their King's drinking game revenge story, and it reminded me of mine. Background: I'm a 5 foot tall, tiny girl, but I grew up in a heavy drinking family, so I have excellent drinking capacity. I'm also in law school with insufferable know-it-alls and boys who think they're the best at anything and everything, especially when compared with girls. This was about 3 years ago. I was in my second year of law school, and we were organizing an event on our campus, and I was a member of the organizing committee along with a bunch of senior boys. Generally, people join these committees because we'd get this one room with a balcony in our academic block all to ourselves for weeks, where we would chill and drink and smoke up, literally all anyone does in law schools in my country. There were two fifth-year boys, law is a five-year course here, in the committee with me, one of them genuinely there to work too, I'll call him M, the other there to make sure everyone had a good time, I'll call him P. The first time M and I pulled an all-nighter to make sure everything was in place for the next day, P joined us to make sure his friend M also had adequate alcohol. He asked me if I wanted some too, I said duh. So P gets out these glasses and pours some whiskey in both. I like whiskey, so no issues. He then started adding some water, because we didn't have ice, in the glasses. And my natural reaction was, wait, you're diluting it? They looked at me a little weirdly, we had a tiny bit of conversation, and realized that I prefer my whiskey neat, but they cannot handle neat whiskey at all, so they always dilute it with chilled water. M was cool with it, but it irked P a lot, because he could not fathom how a tiny girl, 3 years younger than him, could claim to drink neat whiskey. Since then, he decided he would try to get me super drunk just to prove that he had better capacity than me. Kept making jabs at me every time I refused a drink. I was still working during the day. About me being a pussy and that I am all talk, but I can't actually drink much. It was pretty annoying. This one time, I was drinking plain Coca-Cola, not spiked, because I was working on something, and P decided to take a sip of it because he assumed it would be spiked. Usually, all my drinks are. He realized it wasn't, and then he started teasing me about how I need really strong drinks, like Coke mixed with Pepsi, dripping with sarcasm. My revenge happened the last night of our event. Everything wrapped up, we had a bit of a party in our organizing room with all the volunteers, and we decided to play the game Kings. It's a drinking game that involves, frankly, a lot of drinking, and P suggested it, hoping to get me smashed. It's basically a deck of cards, and each card has a designated action. For example, 6 is for the chicks, so when someone picks up a 6, all the girls drink. One of the cards is a pair card. If you draw that card, you choose another person to drink every time you do the entire night till someone else picks up a pair card. I was lucky enough to get that pair card early on, and immediately I chose P as my pair. We also had an unofficial rule in the beginning that P himself added, which was that in case of pairs, the pair has to drink the same amount of alcohol that the original person drinks. I had some friends playing too, and they immediately caught on to what I was planning, so every time someone picked up a card that required them to choose someone to drink, they picked me. I would purposely lose the categories round, so I would have to drink. If I did 3 shots, P would also have to do 3 shots. Hardly half an hour later, P was out of it. We were both drinking literally the same amount of alcohol, but he was smashed while I was still in control of my senses and playing the game. P couldn't even enjoy the rest of the party because he was passed out while we all had fun till early morning. We're a tiny campus, so word spread around fast. Since then, everyone started teasing P about not being able to handle his alcohol and for losing to a tiny 20-year-old girl. P never tried to pick on me for anything again, and my entire campus hails me as some sort of drinking legend. As someone who stopped drinking in 2004, I feel like I missed out on a lot of games, but it was always fun to be the one who was still in their right mind watching everybody else make absolute fools of themselves. On to our next story, small motorbike versus small waves pinky finger. I should preface this by saying I was raised by a narcissist, and I'm extremely passive-aggressive as a result. Years ago, I bought my first motorbike, a tiny 125cc bike that with my 82kg body weight could barely do 90km an hour on a flat road and would lose speed going up hills despite me revving as hard as I could. That was my first motorbike, and I loved her with my whole heart. At the time of this incident, I was still on my L plates, my learner license, which requires the driver and rider to display a yellow square with a large black L on the back of their motorbike. I had two, one attached next to the number plate and one tied to my backpack. So I'm cruising along on my bike to visit my family, and I'm heading up this one notorious hill that is deceptively steep on the incline. It curves around, so it's hard to see, but it gets quite steep over the distance, so I'd hit the bottom of the hill at 90 and be doing 70 at the top. I'd always take the left lane, slow lane in Australia, so that people could overtake safely on my right, the fast lane, if they needed to. I was the only vehicle on that stretch of road when a man in a very expensive looking car decides to come flying around the curve and almost hit the back of the motorbike. He would have easily been doing 110 plus in the 90 speed limit, and instead of moving over and overtaking safely, he decided to slam on his brakes, sit inches from my bike, and beep his horn while screaming at me to get off the road. I move as far over in the left lane as I can without riding into the shoulder, but he won't overtake. He just screams and beeps and revs until I get to the top of the hill when he finally decides to overtake and move off. I cruise on down the far side of the hill and suddenly realize he's gotten caught in the lights at the off-ramp. So I carry on down the off-ramp and cruise to the front of the queue for the lights. Lane filtering is legal here, and stop my bike just in front of his car. Wait for the lights, the light goes green, I move forward about a meter and stall the bike. I've seen some shades of red and purple in my life, but never anything like the color of douchebag's face. He completely loses it, screaming and swearing and threatening to have me arrested and or shot. The lady in the car behind him gets out her phone and starts recording him. I ignore him, restart the bike in a belch of black smoke, and just as the light turns yellow, I speed off around the corner, leaving him there, throwing a massive tantrum. Would I do that again, now that I'm older and wiser? Hell no, but it felt so good at the time. My wife and I joke about this all the time when we're out taking drives in the car. Some idiot will be riding our butt all the way up a road, and then all of a sudden just scream past us in the passing lane. Until, a couple moments later, we're right beside them again, at a red light. That little act of aggression of yours, it got you so far now, didn't it, sweetheart? I'd like to thank all three OPs for posting their stories to the Petty Revenge subreddit. You can visit them at the links in the description below. Please go there and give them an upvote. Once again, this is Rob from Karma Comment Chameleon saying thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please hit that subscribe button, drop a like, and share it with your friends. And we'll see you in the next one.